Hi students, today we are going to discuss about a case study on applications of digital networks in COVID-19 pandemic planning and response. We know that with high transmissibility and no effective vaccine or therapy, COVID-19 is now a globally pandemic. Government coordinated efforts across the globe have focused on containment and mitigation with varying degrees of success. Countries that have maintained low COVID-19 per capita mortality rates appear to share strategies that include early surveillance, testing, contact tracing, and strict quarantine. The scale of coordination and data management required for effective implementation of these strategies has helped most successful countries rely on adapting digital technology and integrating it into policy and healthcare. This viewpoint provides a framework for the application of digital technologies in pandemic management and response, highlighting ways in which successful countries have adopted those technologies for pandemic planning, surveillance, testing, contact tracing, quarantine, and healthcare. Okay. And thus, here, COVID-19, an infectious disease caused by the novel severe acute respiratory syndrome coronavirus 2, SARS-CoV-2, is a globally pandemic with high transmissibility, a case fatality rate greater than 1%, and no effective antiviral therapy or vaccine. A mainstay of pandemic management has been containment and mitigation. However, that despite relying on established public health principles, countries across the world have had varying degrees of success in managing the burden of COVID-19. We know that very well. Here, the digital health technology can facilitate pandemic strategy and a response in ways that are difficult to achieve manually. Countries such as South Korea have integrated digital technology into government coordinated containment and mitigation processes, including surveillance, containment, testing, contact tracing, and strict quarantine, which would be associated with the early flattening of that incidence curves. Although South Korea has incurred only 0.5 COVID-19 deaths per 1 lakh or 1 crore people. In USA, about 3 times as many intensive care units beds per 1 lakh people and ranked number 1 in pandemic preparedness before COVID-19 pandemic, has assigned 10 times as many deaths in capita. And this viewpoint provides a framework for the application of digital technologies in pandemic management and response, highlighting the ways in which successful countries have adopted and integrated digital technologies for pandemic planning, surveillance, testing, contact tracing, quarantine, and healthcare. Okay, here we have some initiatives used in pandemic preparedness and response. Here we have tracking. Here the functioner tracks disease activity in real time. Here digital technology provides data dashboards, migration maps, machine learning, real time data from smartphones and wearable technology. Okay, and also we have screening for infection, and thus it screens individuals and populations. Here we use digital technologies like artificial intelligence, digital thermometers, mobile phone applications like that we have. And thus, what's the use of planning and tracking? What's the use of planning and tracking in digital technologies? Here we use big data and artificial intelligence have helped to facilitate COVID-19 preparedness and the tracking of people. And so the spread of infection in several countries, we use the tools like migration maps, which use mobile phones, mobile payment applications, and social media to collect real-time data on the location of people, allow Chinese authorities to track the movement of people who had visited the Wuhan market and the pandemic epicenter. With these data, machine learning models were developed to forecast the regional transmission of dynamics of SARS-CoV-2 and guide border checks and surveillance. Okay. AI is not without limitations and requires training with COVID-19 datasets. Most of the AI predictive models so far have used Chinese samples, which might not be generalizable. In addition to the absence of historical training data, social media and the other online traffic have created noise in big data sets. Potentially, producing overfitted or so-called lucky good fit models. Thus, noise must be flattered before accurate trends and predictions can be discerned. The accuracy, validity, and the reliability of each AI forecast should be assessed with interpreting projections. Okay, with proper interpreting projections. Okay, and also this digital technologies include screening for infection. Here, we use systematic screening technologies or expansive and require trained personnel by using AI. The restricting their uptake in many countries, the incubation period and the relatively high prevalence of asymptomatic infection compared with other infectious diseases that limits the effectiveness of digital systems that screen vital signs or self-reporting of symptoms only. Researchers at the European Center for Disease Prevention and Control estimate that a majority of passengers from Chinese cities would not be detected by screening because of these factors. Okay, and also we have contact tracing. Here, contact tracing applications are not without pitfalls. Not all exposure requires quarantine, such as when the exposed individuals are wearing personal protective equipment or separated by thin walls penetrable by mobile phone signals. On the other hand, relevant exposure could be missed when individuals do not carry their mobile phones or without mobile devices. In addition, researchers at Oxford University have suggested that 60% of country's population would need to use a contact tracing application for it to be an effective mitigation strategy. And also, digital technologies plays an important role in quarantine and self-isolation. Here, mobile phone solutions for a quarantine enforcement can be bypassed if individuals leave their quarantine location without their devices. Self-reported surveys such as those used in QR code systems only work when individuals are symptomatic and report their symptoms accurately. However, such technological innovations could provide benefits when used in combination with other set strategies. And also, it provides applications in clinical management. Okay. Virtual care platforms using video conferencing and digital monitoring have been used to worldwide to deliver remote healthcare to patients as a means of reducing their exposure to SARS-CoV-2 and healthcare institutions. In Canada, clinicians to patient video visits have increased from approximately 1,000 visits per day in February 2022 to 14,000 per day by mid-May. Countries such as USA and Australia have also harnessed digital technology to provide remote care to patients with the chronic conditions or with mild or moderate COVID-19 illness in their homes. If implemented and delivered appropriately, a virtual care can increase healthcare access during the pandemic and after, but possible risks could include misdiagnosis, equipment malfunction, privacy breaches, and cost to the healthcare system. Okay. We have some risk of digital technology. And also, the integration of digital technology into pandemic policy and response could be one of the several characteristic features of countries that have flattened their COVID-19 incidence curves and maintained low mortality rates. In the race to contain the spread of highly transmissible virus, countries that have quickly deployed digital technologies to facilitate planning, surveillance, testing, contact tracing, quarantine, and clinical management that have remained front runners in managing disease burden. The comprehensive responses of countries that have been successful at containment and mitigation can provide insight to other countries that are still facing a surge of cases. Thank you.